there's a huge challenge in just delivering the cells. So the very nature of subretinal injection is to make a retinal tear. So how you control the delivery and the recovery from the delivery is a key challenge. There are certainly companies developing better instrumentation and better intraoperative monitoring of the delivery device that we, of the delivery process that we hope to take advantage of. The main challenge I think that everyone recognizes is that even if you're successful in putting photoreceptors like cones into the eye in their correct anatomic location, will they make synapses with the next cells in the relay to the brain? And that is really a problem of the host disease environment. Is there too much scar in the eye at the stage that you deliver your photoreceptors for the cells to be able to make extensions? Or is there too much degeneration of the bipolar cells, for example, as a process parallel to the degeneration of the cones so that you don't have anything functionally to integrate with? Those are the two big challenges. And I think we can address them by really exquisitely phenotyping the patients early on and using advanced imaging techniques as well as functional visual testing afterwards to really try to define the right patient population and the right metrics for following integration of the cones into the visual circuitry.